So a chaff cart is one of the old tools. I actually brought them out here from Canada, I think, back in the day to feed sheep, ironically. It really just is a tool to collect just the chaff fraction, put it in the cart, and then later those dumps are often burnt. Sometimes they're grazed and then burnt. Sometimes they're grazed and just seeded through. But really it's just catching that chaff fraction and putting it in a pile. All of the harvest weed seed control tools are about as effective as one another. Michael Walsh has done trials all around Australia comparing the different tools, found them all to be equally as effective as one another. They will remove about 60 to 70% of the ryegrass that's standing in a paddock and maybe 70 to 80% of the wild radish seed. So Michael Walsh's trials, 25 of them, found that where they use any of the different tools, the following year, the ryegrass germination in autumn was reduced by 55%. So, look, they are removing about 60 or 70% of the weed seeds, which results in a 50% reduction in germination next year. You do that enough years in a row, and your seed bank just keeps going down and can get on top of the problem. One, we've got to thresh it hard enough in the rotor. Secondly, we've got to open the rotor up enough, open the grates up enough to get the weed seeds onto the sieve. And then when we're sieving them, we don't want too much wind, so we blow the weed seeds up into the straw stream. Some harvesters aren't as good at separating chaff and straw, so what you have is a baffle, and a baffle is like a curved shaped piece of steel often, like where my arm is or where my hand is there. So the idea of that baffle is to direct the chaff below the baffle and onto the belt and keep the straw above the baffle. And as I said, if we don't want the wind too high, because if we have the wind high, we'll blow the weed seeds right over the top of that baffle and they'll go out with the straw. What we're trying to do is get the weed seeds in the chaff, under the baffle and onto the belt so they end up in the chaff cart. So the nutrient removal isn't as big as a windrow burn, for example. So in windrow burning, we're putting roughly half of the residue in the paddock into a windrow and burning it. With a chaff cart, it can be 10 to 20% of the residue in the paddock, which is probably more than you might think when you look at the piles out there. But well, I've measured it, and it is around that 10 to 20% of the leftover residue ends up in the chaff dumps. That roughly equates in wheat, per tonne of wheat grain harvested, about $2 to $2.50 in nutrients. And the main nutrients are nitrogen and potassium. But perhaps where you graze them, that nutrient drain isn't quite as much. So a chaff cart second hand with a conveyor belt can be anywhere from, well, the bottom price could be as low as $10,000, but typically $10,000 to $20,000 for a second hand chaff cart. A new one is in the order of $70,000 to $80,000. If we look at that, those costs, including that finance, maintenance, extra fuel and so on, a bit of labour to burn the dumps, we're talking about $7 or $8 a hectare to run a chaff cart. And then we add to that the nutrient removal. So a 3-tonne wheat crop, for example, is about $7.50. So all up, we could be talking roughly $15 a hectare, depending on the yield of the crop. That's the ballpark sort of figure.